الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد. And then when the soul is taken, when the soul is taken and the people have buried you in your graves, the people have buried you in your graves, they put the dirt on top of you, now you are left. You can't drive out with your flashy cars now. You can't call any of your boys to help you out of the grave. No one can help you in this grave. And then the two angels will come. And remember these names, my dear brothers and sisters. Remember these two names. Because these are the two angels that will question you. Munkar and Nakir. They will come and question you. And they will ask you three questions. They will ask you three questions. And what are these questions? Who is your Lord? What is your Deen? And who is your Prophet? And only those with a sincere Iman and who did righteous deeds in this dunya will be able to answer those questions. You can memorize the answers as much as you want. As much as you want. But your tongue won't be able to utter those words until you do righteous acts in this world. And this will be the final test for the believer. And as for that person who cannot answer the questions, he will get smashed with a hammer. He will get smashed with a hammer until he turns into dust. Subhanallah. And our hearts, nothing happens to our hearts when we hear about the punishment of the grave. Nothing happens to our hearts when we hear about the punishment of the grave. Our hearts become hard like rocks. But look at the companions. Look at the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. In a hadith narrated by Asma bint Abi Bakr in Sahih Bukhari, she says that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave a khutbah and described the punishment and the trials of the grave, the Sahaba started to cry. And they cried so loudly that she could no longer hear the khutbah. This was the effect that it had on the Sahaba. Yeah, look at us today. You can talk about death all day long, but nothing happens to us. Our hearts are still hard. We have become a people of hard hearts. And why did the Sahaba cry? Because they had Iman. Because they had Iman. And they were in constant remembrance of death. And today when we see Muslims passing away, or we see Muslims that die, and we go to someone's house to pay condolences, the only thing we do is talk about the dunya. The only thing we do, even though we have been given a reminder, that wake up, that it may be you next in this grave, that it may be you next that people come to pray about. But no, all we talk about is the dunya. The dunya and what business deal we will do next. And you will see when you go to a funeral how people can put a body in the grave, throw dust onto him and throw the dirt onto him, and then just laugh and joke. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if the Sahaba felt something when they just heard about death, then how come we don't feel anything? How come we don't feel anything when we see a dead person being put in the grave? When we see a dead person being put in the pit, in the grave, in the black hole, when he will be all by himself, and when the two angels will come and ask him those questions. Subhanallah. And the worst thing is that the hardness of our heart is a disease. It's a disease. And we spend so much money trying to cure small illnesses, but how much time and how much money have we spent trying to cure the illness of our hearts? Our hearts have become black. And it's only with the remembrance of death, it's only with the remembrance of death and the hereafter can we soften our hearts. And subhanallah, to finish inshallah, I would like to recite Surah At-Takathur. And just look at the meaning of Surah At-Takathur. And how much it really means to us. And how much it refers to us, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر. And the mutual rivalry in this world diverts you from what? Diverts you from death, my dear brothers and sisters, until you visit your graves. كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون. And you shall come to know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again reiterates, you shall come to know when you are in your graves. كَلَّا لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ إِلْمَ الْيَقِينَ لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمَ. And then you will know what the end result is for piling up what you have done in this dunya. You will know the end result for piling up of what you occupied yourself with in the dunya. And then you will wish that you had never done it. you will wish that you never had done that deed, never had piled up all that wealth, all those bank balances, all those cars, all those houses. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you will then see the fire. You will see the fire. لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ ثُمَّ لَتَرَوُنَّهَا عَيْنَ الْيَقِينِ ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. And again, you shall see it with your own eyes. You shall see the fire with your own eyes, my dear brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that we will see the fire with our own eyes. And then on that day, you will be questioned. You will be questioned and asked about the delights of the dunya that you occupied yourselves with. The delights of the dunya that you thought would help you in this dunya, but will not help you in the akhirah. Subhanallah. And when, my dear brothers and sisters, when are we going to be ready to die? When? And ask yourself this question, are we ready to die? And what have we done to help ourselves in the hereafter? Ask yourself this question today. Don't just leave this khutbah and think, okay, it's another guy, another Maulvi stood on the member. No, when you go home today, try to think what you will do next. Because you may not see till tomorrow. And the scholars says that the scholars warned against those who think that they can change their deeds and say we will do it tomorrow. You may not live till tomorrow. What guarantee have you got that you will live till tomorrow? And this dunya, my dear brothers and sisters, life and death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. He created so that He can test who is best in good deeds. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Mulk, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. To test you in good deeds, to see who is the best in good deeds. My brothers and sisters, please take this as a reminder today. And when you leave this khutbah, just think about where we are heading. Where we are heading, and don't delay things for tomorrow. Don't delay things for tomorrow, because we may not be here till tomorrow. So I ask you today, do you want your grave to be a garden of paradise, or do you want it to be a pit of hell? The choice is yours.